Morning to all teachers. My name is Himanshi of class 5th G. Today we will read a book of English of class 5th. Let's read it. The poem name is Ice Cream Man. Let's go. When summer in the city and makes a blaze of heat, the ice cream man with his little cart goes tramping down the street. Beneath his round umbrella, oh what a joyful sight to see him fill the cones with mounds of cooling brown and white vanilla, chocolate, strawberry or jelly, thanks to drink from bottle full of frosty. If his green, orange, white or pink, his cart might be a flower bed of roses and sweet peas. The way the children clustered around that as thick as honey bees. This poem writer name is Rachel Field. Thank you.
My name is Jaykumar. I study in class 5G. In this video, I am telling a story named The Tailor and His Friend. Kalu the tailor had a shop near the river. He made colorful pants and shirts for children. Appu the elephant was his friend. Appu came to his shop every day. Kalu gave him many nice things to eat. One day, Kalu wanted to play a trick. He did not give Appu anything to eat. He took out his needle instead and pricked Appu's trunk. Appu ran away in pain. 2 days later, Appu came down to the river and filled his trunk with water. He reached Kalu's shop and threw water everywhere. All the new clothes became wet. Appu shook his trunk and said, "An elephant never forgets." Kalu said, "I'm sorry, my friend. Let's be friends again." Kalu and Appu became good friends again, forever. Thank you.
My name is Shani. Today I am going to read a story. Let's start. Deep in a forest stood a very tall tree. Its leafy branch is spread out like strong arms. This tree was the home of a flock of wild geese. They felt safe there. One of the geese was white old bird. He noticed a small creeper at the foot of the tree. He spoke to the other bird about it. "Do you see that creeper?" he said to them. "Red, do you see?" "Yes, the story." "Why must we destroy it?" asked the geese. "In surprise, it is so small. What harm can it do?" "My friend," replied the wise old bird, "that little creeper will soon grow as it creeps up the tree. It will become thick and strong." "What of that?" asked the geese. "What harm can a creeper do us?" "Don't you see?" replied the wise bird. "With the help of that creeper, it will be possible for someone to climb this tree. A hunter can come up and kill us all." "Well, there no hurry then," replied the creeper. "Is very small. It would be a pity to destroy it now." Destroy the keeper while it is still young, the old bird advised. "Now it is standard and you can cut it easily. Later it will become hard and you will not be able to cut it." We will see, answered the bird, but they did not destroy the creeper. They followed the wise old bird advice. As the creeper grew, it began winding its way up the tree, stronger and stronger. It became a little, it was as strong as cedars. One morning, when the geese had gone out in search of a food, A hunter came to the, "So this is where the wild geese live," he said to himself. "When they come back in the evening, I shall catch them." The hunter climbed up the tree with the help of the creeper. He got to the top and spread his